3D graphics are the standard for AAA games and are relatively common in the indie scene. 2D graphics, on the other hand, have their charm and a nostalgic appeal. But since the beginning of video game history, various techniques have emerged to try to add an extra dimension. These techniques attempt to emulate a 3D visual, but usually have some kind of limitation that prevents players from truly exploring the game in 3D, resulting in a middle ground often called 2.5D or pseudo 3D. I personally find these techniques fascinating and charming. They are a great example of people's creativity and ingenuity, creating impressive and fun games with relatively low computational cost. So in today's video I decided to discuss the different techniques and talk a bit about how they work and present some examples, if possible from projects made with Pygame, and some of them are actually my own projects. Parallax scrolling. The first technique that is actually used in many 2D platform games is parallax scrolling. With it, you can give the sensation of depth by using different layers for the background. Each layer moves at a different speed depending on its distance from the camera. That is, closer layers move faster, while more distant layers move slower. Oblique projection, which usually is simply referred as isometric projection. Sometimes it uses pre-rendered graphics that look 3D, with several rotations for each sprite. To me, it looks more like a middle ground between a platformer and a top-down game. You still move the player in a similar way as in a top-down game, while seeing a bit from the side too. Many real-time strategy games use this technique, such as StarCraft and Age of Empires, among many others. I have never worked with this technique myself, but a very cool project made with Python that I follow from time to time is called Isometria, made by Big Whoop. You can even play the demo version on Steam, a game with a high level of detail and very polished. The limitations of this technique include the fixed camera direction, which always views objects from a specific angle, and the lack of true depth, as objects are always the same size, no matter how far they are from the camera. Sprite stacking is a technique where you draw the sprites in layers and render them with a small offset, resulting in a visual similar to the isometric technique, but with the benefit that you can freely rotate the sprites, while in the isometric technique, each direction of the sprite has to be drawn separately. The Fluffy Potato has a project that uses this technique and even made a very good tutorial on the subject. Z-scaling. The next technique is about scaling along the Z-axis, meaning making the sprites closer to the camera larger while those further away are smaller. Many racing games use this strategy. If you look closely, even the track can be made of several sprites lined up, getting smaller as they move away, or bigger as they move closer. To create elevations and dips, you can apply offsets to these sprites. I use this technique in some of my games, usually associated with the raycasting technique. The main limitation here is that you usually cannot look up and down, as the sprites are made to be viewed from the front. But you can cheat a bit by translating the image in the opposite direction you are looking, but it's not really the same. The raycasting technique, which was used in the first first-person shooter games like Wolfenstein 3D. I have also used it in some or most of my games, even before starting to use Pygame. The basic idea is that you have a map, usually made of blocks, and using rays of vision, you calculate the distance to the nearest wall for each column of pixels on the screen. Then you render a column of pixels scaled according to this distance. This strategy is practically the same as scaled sprites, but with wall texture pieces. I usually use these two techniques combined, with raycasting for the walls and sprites for the objects. I even use this technique to create a first-person version of Super Mario, but instead of blocks for walls, I use the blocks to make the platforms. And to be honest, I have never seen someone using raycasting this way before. Mode 7 or Floorcasting. Another very famous technique is Mode 7 from the Super Nintendo, which consists of rotating and scaling a plane, where the most famous example is Super Mario Kart. The idea is relatively simple. A rotated texture is drawn line by line, scaled according to the distance. For example, for the ground, the top lines are smaller and the bottom ones are larger. It's also often used in conjunction with scaled sprites and raycasting, or at least in a similar technique, for example to draw the floor and ceiling, also having the same camera limitations, not being able to look up and down for real, just translating the image to get a similar effect. Heightmaps. Another type of raycasting is done using a texture with the heights of each point on the map and drawing columns of pixels, scaled accordingly to the height and distance. From what I know, it was used in some flight simulation games in the early 90s. Recently, I found this project by G Popcorn that uses this technique. The result is very interesting. Being a type of raycasting technique, it also has the same limitations, like not being able to really look up and down. Pre-rendered 3D backgrounds. To conclude, a slightly more advanced technique that I haven't seen in any project made with Pygame yet, but I have seen one made in Java by my fellow Brazilian Leo Ono. The idea is to use pre-rendered scenarios in a similar style as the first Resident Evil games, but at a higher level. Instead of a fixed camera angle, it follows the character on the screen. In an effect similar to Google Maps Street View, Leo has a small series of videos showing a bit of how the technique works, and the source code is also available. So, that's it for today's video. With these techniques, you can add a bit more depth to your games, without all the complications associated with developing actual 3D games. If you know of any other technique that I haven't mentioned here, feel free to share it in the comments. Thanks for watching, and until the next time.